Tilo, Kunath. I'm a group leader at the Center for Regenerative Medicine, and we've just come out of a Cabaret of Dangerous Ideas show on Dolly the Sheep, major discovery or minor destruction. For me, I think she was a major discovery. She really changed our view of biology, that biology doesn't necessarily need to go forward. We can go backwards in time, go sideways, and we use the idea of Dolly to take cells and reprogram them to make very useful stem cells that we use in my lab. So she's influenced the work that I do and many other people around the world.
I'm Helen Sang. I work at the Roslin Institute of the University of Edinburgh, and I've been taking part in the Cabaret of Dangerous Ideas. And I took the position that she's really a minor distraction and we should move on. Well, Dolly the Sheep was all about cloning, and we don't use cloning anymore. We still have programs at the Roslin Institute for genetic modification of farm animal species. And cloning is an old technology. It's not very efficient, and we have much more efficient technologies now. And I think that we should move on and discuss what we could use those technologies for and not keep going back over old ground.
I think the cloning itself will probably not be a major thing in 20 years, but the inspiration of the type of stem cell technology that that Dolly inspired will have a big impact. I think a lot of cell repair, a lot of tissue repair, a lot of changing one cell type into another will be happening in 20 years. And this all stemmed from the discovery of Dolly, that you could take cells and reverse them in time.
Well, I'm Miguel Garcia Sancho. I'm a historian of science working in the University of Edinburgh. Well, I still think it was a major achievement, but not in the way scientists expected, because what scientists wanted was to produce another sheep that was both cloned and genetically modified. So Dolly is a very good example of how scientific progress cannot be predicted and scientific imagination cannot be limited by very rigid policies that think that scientists can predict the application of the research. And also science doesn't necessarily have to be commercial in order to be successful, because Dolly was not a commercial success, but I think it was a scientific success.
I think it's really important that we discuss our work, the scientists' work, with the public. It's a responsible thing to do. It's a thing that really I get a lot of enjoyment out of, but I think the public needs to know what we're doing. We can't sit in ivory towers and do science. And also the bottom line is a lot of the public fund our research, so they need to hear about what we're doing, and they need to hear it sometimes in a fun setting like the Fringe, right? And it's also a two-way street. I also get a lot of back from talking to the public. I get sometimes ideas talking to the public, and so it's not just a one-way communication. As it was today, we had a lot of great questions in CoDI today.